Okay, so I would like to talk about Garrett code review system, and I don't know who used Garrett here. Oh, impressive, half guys use Garrett. This is open source code review that was primarily developed by Google and now used by many open source projects like OpenStack and Wikimedia, and also has very big usage in enterprises like SAP develop intern all their project on Garrett, and Google and Sony Ericsson as the maintainer of Garrett currently have 6 people. This is all from enterprises that full time working on Garrett. So I just present one small feature, and some guys ask me why we need it. And I just thought, okay, let maybe, who know GitHub, someone? Okay, almost everyone know what GitHub is. And the question is, as a little motivation, what is your workflow with GitHub? You go to the web page and you create a repository, and you add some files, and now what GitHub actually is this repository browser, and combined with, I think it's small, yes. It is a repository browser, and red guy, this is our edit button. So you always is a relative new feature in GitHub since 2008 and 11. They extended it to support almost every use case to manipulate content of repository directly in browser. So if you click on this button, you'll get editor, and you can change this directly in browser in GitHub. You, let's say what you can do more with plus, you can add new file directly in this directory where you are at this time, and it's somehow hidden feature you can rename because it is input field. You can directly rename the file. Okay, once you did it, and for markup file content, you have preview button. So if this is ASCII doctor or RST or something else, you can immediately render it as ready. Okay, once you did all this, you have two options to commit if you have right access to this repository to master branch, or you can create a pull request to another branches. And even if you haven't forked GitHub repository, you have this magic button that do one click workflow for you, fork and create for you the editor with this button content, with this file content. Okay, so now the problem that we are trying to solve here, Garrett, LibreOffice is using Garrett. So if you contribute to Garrett, the easiest way for reviewer is to review your patch, and then your reviewer review your patch, and then he say, okay, nice idea, unfortunately it sucks. Okay, so what reviewer do at that point? The change owner, okay, 10 days, nothing happened, okay, it disappeared, I don't know. Maybe the right workflow is, in this case, to switch to local branch from where this patch was pushed, or pull this again with download. Okay, I'm not signing in. And rework. Reamend the commit and repush again. Okay, so what, but for small changes, the question is, where is my edit button like this? And in Garrett community, you always the guys ask on the mailing list, okay, where's the edit button? The other contribution platforms offer me this button. So where's this in? Okay, so I looked at this task, how it can be addressed with open source. Garrett is Apache 2 license. GitHub is closed source. Obviously, you cannot take it and be cool and provide your contributor one click and the 100% workflow in browser, right? So they maybe there's GitHub Enterprise. They charge you per year, per seat, and that's not cool anymore. So the cool way to offer cool feature in open source software. That is the challenge here. Okay, so let's say, why would one, I already show you the other, this last point in motivation, this other collaboration platform already support this feature, but also maybe it is easier for reviewer sometimes, it's a really trivial change to just edit this one line and it is already done. So it just reviewer can then merge this change immediately without this unneeded comment, wait, re-review loop cycle, and etc. And if someone translate German comment in LibreOffice, we have maybe you know thousands of files with still German comments. So you to translate, say, two statements from German and English, you have to pull 2 GB repository and conduct the page, upload it to Garrett, and so on. So just idea to for small task, how could we do that? How could we solve the problem? Because in browser, we don't have Git, right, in JavaScript implemented, so I can just manipulate my commit, manipulate my tree if I want to rename or remove or add or change the content. Okay, so how is this regular patch set, regular ref is represented in Garrett? So just to show you the one change. So if you one specific change that I'll demonstrate how to change now in Garrett in browser. Okay, this is how Garrett, the magic behind Garrett. If you push to Garrett a change, this change, so it pushes a special ref. Ref changes, this is a sharded representation, the two last digits from this change, the change number. And 5 is this patch set number. So if you amend your patch and repush again, so it's just the new patch set is added. So this is normal ref, like all changes are represented. So the idea is to say, okay, if this is my normal patch set representation in Garrett. So the idea is, okay, first of all, I want to support different user. So if Alice or Bob change the patch in browser, so they of course should get their own reference. So I extended the path where the refs stored with user, and I change the sharded change representation as with this user ID representation. And okay, edit suffix is IMA constant, and this is my change number. I don't need to shard it already because I sharded the user. On P, this is important thing. This is a patch set the edit is based on. You should imagine that the complexity with Garrett that you have many different patch set for the same change. If you upload new patches, it's patch set number 6. So that if you create an edit, you have to base it on specific patch set. And it is possible that this patch set, that you get a new patch set. This is the last point that, okay, in a normal edit can be published and can be deleted and is promoted to normal patch set. So in this case, I would create an edit on top of page set 5, and I'd publish it and create page set 6 for you in browser. Okay, it's not directly in browser. Garrett, this is a GUID-based application. So you have a REST endpoint on the server side. I think I needed 10 new REST endpoints to implement that feature. And the communication between client and server manipulating GGit, as in Git implementation in Java, the whole tree manipulation in memory for you. Okay. So creating new draft change. Okay, so the disadvantage of, I skip this. The disadvantage of GitHub is, okay, this look nice because there are a lot of people, designer who work on it, but there are one serious problem with GitHub approach, because this repo browser, and you, as a, every time you are browsing specific file, and you can only change this file. So it's totally sucks, because it's my Git history is immediately broken, because if I have a change in mind that I want to change 10 files in my commit, I can do it in GitHub with inline edit feature, because in this case, I would get 10 commits. I don't want 10 commits. I don't want to poison my Git history. So this is a serious limitation of this approach. And this solved very nicely in Garrett. Why? Because the concept of Garrett is the concept of change. You have a change, and you manipulate a file in context of this change. So if I want to create a new modification of anything in Garrett, I need a context. In this case, a change. So I have to provide, it was also not possible, to provide a way how to start, how to create and change in Garrett, because until now, the only way to create and change in Garrett is to go to terminal, conduct a commit, and push it to Garrett. And then the change is created. But if I want to start from scratch in only browser 100% workflow, I need to find a way to do that. Of course, if you change already there and the reviewer say just change something, you don't need to create a change. But to support 100% workflow, you have to solve this. Okay, so how do we solve this? Okay, to create a change, you need three things. You need a project, because every Garrett installation, like in LibreOffice or in OpenStack, has hundreds of thousands of projects. So to create a change, you need a project context, you need a commit message, and you need a branch. So it was okay, discussable where this button, where to put this button. So the decision was to put it on the project change of on the project change of Garrett. So just to show you, okay, so just to understand, I can show you the whole solved thing on Garrett at LibreOffice, because it's a little bit outdated, but all my changes were merged in Garrett upstream, in the nice story about Garrett nice upstream. It's really hard to get merge changes in Garrett itself, but if they are merged, then they deploy every day, as it's really, really nice thing. They deploy every day master on all their Google source, where Android review, GUID review, and other big project using. So this is the button. And now, because I am in context of my project, it is clear for what to create this change for. So in this case, I create commit for Garrett project itself, right? So I just, of course, I support auto-completion, that all branches that in system known, you can say, okay, let's say this one, and then this force them, and just just create upstream new change. And of course, I'm navigated directly in this change, right? So we have now a change at Garrett created from browser. In Garrett, we have draft or not draft changes that mean that it's actually hidden. And okay, we decided to create it as a draft so that nobody see it. And you, one thing, it is unusual in Garrett, probably you never seen it before, that the file table is empty, right? So this is empty change, nothing there. I would like to put something later. Okay, so this is only one way, but it's a little bit not very straightforward to go to project, to select the right one and branch. So usual case, usual use case, that you already have some project. This is a new one, status draft. So I have another project, another change already. This is this presentation. This presentation that I show you, it was uploaded a couple of days ago on Garrett. Let's say I would like to do a follow-up change for this change, right? As you want a series of changes, some groundwork, and then you use this feature. It's usually done as a series, as a topic, right? So that's very usual thing to do is to create a follow-up of this change. If I create a follow-up of this change, I don't need to say that this is master, I don't need to say this is a Garrett project, because this change is already on master, already on Garrett. All I need to create a follow-up of this change is one click. If you need more than one click, that is, you maybe did something wrong. So one click, I just say here, guys, force them 2016, more cool feature. Okay, so I create this one. It is second change is created on top of this change. Also draft, also empty, and I can populate it with the other feature. I don't do that now. One is enough. Okay, so okay, that is this how create a change, and by clicking follow up button, we create a follow up change. Okay, so we have a change, or we have already existing change. So I need to populate it somehow, right? Okay, that is the limitation in Garrett. This is how GitHub is better at this, because it's a combination of browser, of repository browser, and manipulation. So Garrett is not repository browser, it's a code review system. And for repository browser, he support some other tools like Git tiles, like Git web, like CGIT, like Git bleed, and so on. But it's not Garrett. So if you if you're a Garrett developer, you don't have any contacts with this. This is like a foreign tool for you. So it's not wasn't the trivial. How can you populate a change, an empty change? So so the idea is to just use where's the change? Here's the empty change. No. Okay. Okay, I show you here. Somewhere our open change is gone. No, it's not gone. Open. Okay, so the idea was to switch to edit mode and use the button with add. And of course, it is not really user-friendly to, if I have 1,000 files in the repository, to ask to type, right? So ideally at this point, you would jump to some repository browser like GitHub and navigate in my repository and select. Okay, but you will see that with auto completion you can 2 minutes. What? 2 minutes. Oh, 2 minutes. Okay, with auto completion you can do nice stuff, and the performance is really impressive. That you can change screen. Okay, change change details. Let's say we name this one, this is open. And I have the editor that I can use just something silly and say save and say close. Okay, so I just edit a content to my change in browser, and the code review tool, it's still in place. So of course I can just say, okay, what happened here? Maybe I can just go back to normal. Okay, so you see edit at the right of this page set panel. The edit say that this is something that was done. Okay. So here is the same, but if more page set, you can actually see what was done in context of this edit. So this is change edit. This is not the change. Not a normal patch set. You can publish it and make it a regular patch set, or you can just delete it. And this is basically we can just investigate what happens on the remote side of Garrett. If we ask just to show you how it is now represented, this special thing. Okay, something. Okay, so I will show you another. I don't know why it is yet didn't work. Okay, this is the presentation, and the guy has commented on it. So take this comment, for example. He say remove this word end. Okay, you haven't noticed this presentation was broken, because I haven't addressed the comments. And okay, now the new button here is this fix button or address the comment button that jump exactly to this line in this file in edit mode. And if I click fix, I on this button and this content, I just delete it, save, close, done editing, and now comparison should work just for this manipulation. So you see only one thing was changed from edit to page set 5. So on the remote side, it should work now, I guess. Yes. Okay. So what I have created here on the remote side is this special ref for this edit. And if I publish it, then it became number 6 normal page set. So I addressed the comments from reviewer in 1 second by jumping on the right place in the right file. Okay. Just last. Okay. So we saw editing changes, reviewing change edit. Action publish. You can download the change edits. Okay, the nice extension to this idea is based on this work is actually to allow to resolve conflicts directly in browser. So if your page have conflicts, trivial conflict, of course not if you rebuild the calc core and want to change it, but trivial changes you can maybe based on this feature to do future in directly in browser. Okay, and the similar work is a docs plugin from SAP guys, and that allows to turn wiki based on this feature in wiki system. So there's a preview button and the markdown files and RST file rendered directly in HTML and browser. Okay. Is that it? No question. Thank you.